Okay, I don't agree with this question, but if Nick Sorensen is struggling, do you think they'd be more likely to fire him now that they have a guy like Brandon Staley in the building?
Yeah, if he falls flat on his face, yeah, they could just promote Brandon. Or I guess, I don't know if it'd be a promotion, but yes, they could have Brandon Staley take over as defensive coordinator. But I honestly don't see that happening. Just for the reason that I said, like, I think Staley's going to be able to help Sorensen get up to speed a little bit quicker. I think Sorensen has a lot of experience, like I said, just coaching different things and being kind of called up on a whim to coach things too. So, like, he adapts. He has shown the ability to adapt. When he was with the Jaguars, I think he was a special teams coordinator or something like that.
Yes.
And because Matt Barrows was talking about this too in that podcast, and it was basically like an interim thing. Like, he was just, because it was Schneider, Brian Schneider, was the previous special teams coordinator, and then he left, so Sorensen had to take over. So, I mean, he's kind of used to just having to go in and figure it out, right? And so that's why I do have some faith that it's going to work out, and he'll figure it out as he goes. And then also having Staley in the building too to kind of help them all out.
So I have a separate question for you. If Nick Sorensen, they thought, you know, highly enough about him, do you think it was just because Steve Wilks actually wasn't doing that bad last year is the reason they didn't try to move on to him last year? Like, why do you think this wasn't an immediate hire? If they had a ton of faith and belief in Nick Sorensen, I do feel like if this announcement came out a lot sooner, maybe I'd be a little bit more excited about it. Do you consider, like, the extra time and them interviewing a lot of other people to be a lack of faith in him, or just them doing their due diligence? Because when you talk about that podcast, wasn't it Tim Kawakami that thought Jeff Ulbrich was going to be the guy? So, and I know that might have been, like, there was two conflicting reports coming out. One, I heard it was like, that was never really an option, and so they didn't even understand why that was a rumor. And then a separate report was like, no, Jeff Ulbrich really was interested in the 49ers job position, but the Jets weren't willing to let him go. So do you think that the timing of the hiring of Nick Sorensen is, you know, are you happy that they took that time, or do you take it as like a lack of belief in him?
I'm fine with them taking the time, because like I said, they shot their shot, right? Like, they were trying to get bigger names, and I don't think that's for a lack of, you know, confidence in Sorensen. Especially when you look at the names like Bill Belichick, Steve Spagnuolo, like, obviously, yeah, any of those guys, like, yes, please sign me up. Like, those are candidates that other teams wish they can, like, fire or who they had, if it was acceptable, so they can pick one of those guys up. But, and Jeff Ulbrich as well, you know, I think either one of those names would have been like a slam dunk hire, but I don't think that's a knock on Sorensen. I think as far as internal candidates go, Sorensen was, you know, someone who they thought all along could be that guy if it came down to it.
I felt like he didn't, you know what I mean? Like, even when I was like leaning towards rumors of internal hires, it felt like Daniel Bullocks and a guy like that was getting more attention than Nick Sorensen. So I think that's the interesting part about him, is he has like consistently been, you know, in the rumors of it all. But
I disagree. I think like a lot of fans kind of were putting Bullocks out there more so than actual like connected reports, like, you know, guys from The Athletic and things like that. Like, he was mentioned. That's but I don't
I like that
I think
I like
Sorensen that. Was always like more so mentioned than any of the other internal candidates.
That totally makes sense. Now, really quick, Rick asked us a couple times if we could answer his question, so I just thought that I would bring it up because I saw him in the comments. Do you guys remember the guy that plays with the 49ers? He's not a starter. His name is Alfredo.
Alfredo Gutierrez.
Yeah. I totally
offensive lineman.
Know what you're talking about. I think the 49ers get something also with him where he doesn't count against the cap, right? Because or not mm-hmm. the cap, the roster the, because
He's the international. It's a roster exemption because it's through like the international something program.
Yes, to try to like expand the NFL. Rick, I assume that this was the question you were asking us to get to. If you're just asking how come you never hear about him starting, I think that the 49ers just want to keep him on as like a backup, and maybe they're still developing him. I think they like that he's an extra offensive lineman that doesn't count against the 53-man roster, but he, you know, compared to the other guys that they have starting, isn't up to their caliber. So I hope that was the question that I kept seeing this, please answer the question. So I hope that was it. I got to be honest. I think it's just he's not as talented as the guys that they have starting right now. Is that what you would say?
Yeah, I mean, Randy kind of he may never play, but he's as far as his size, like he's huge. That's intriguing. So it's kind of just like if the 49ers can develop him into anything, like that would be a plus. But he's basically just a plus, just because, you know, he doesn't count against like the roster or anything.
Now, I kind of want to switch it up from the hires that they have done. I think we've done a good job about talking about everyone they brought in, and maybe we need to hear more from the coaches. Potentially we'll hear stuff coming out, I think, at the end of the month of the coaches' meetings. Maybe people ask them more about like